Dr. Mangesh Vaghmare, working as Assistant Professor in Siegerd Institute of Technology, Lonavala. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate Newton's rings experiment. This experiment is based on interference of light. There are different applications of Newton's rings experiment, like determination of wavelength of monochromatic light source, determination of radius of curvature of plano-convex lens, and determination of refractive index of transparent liquid. So out of these three applications, today we are going to perform experiment based on radius of curvature of plano-convex lens. So aim of this experiment is to determine radius of curvature of plano-convex lens. So this is the experimental setup of a Newton's ring experiment. To perform this experiment, we require monochromatic source light. So in this case, we are using sodium vapor lamp. This is a monochromatic source. So as we know, why it's called as a monochromatic source? Because it contains a single wavelength. Then in Newton's ring experiment, assembly of plano convex lens and plain glass plate, that is important. And that assembly is inside this box. So this is monochromatic source. This is biconvex lens in order to obtain parallel beam of light. This is semi-silvered glass plate. It should be placed at an angle 45 degree to the incident beam so that the film which will get developed between the curved surface of the lens and plain glass plate gets illuminated normally. And that plano-convex lens and plain glass plate, that assembly is inside this box. And to observe the pattern, we require a traveling microscope. And as we are going to perform, see this experiment, we are going to perform in dark room. You're supposed to perform this in dark room. So in order to record the readings, we require one table lamp and lens. So this is all about the experimental setup of Newton's ring experiment. Now we'll quickly understand the theory behind this experiment. Experimental arrangement I have already shown. This is a monochromatic light source. In this case, we are using sodium vapor lamp. This is a biconvex lens. It is used to obtain a parallel beam of light. This is semi-silvered glass plate. It should be placed at an angle 45 degree to the incident beam in order to have a normal incidence. Capital M, this is a traveling microscope to observe the pattern. This is a plano-convex lens and plain glass plate. Now in Newton's ring experiment, this plano-convex lens and plain glass plate, this assembly is very, very important. So when plano-convex lens of a large focal length, when it is placed on plain glass plate, an air film of varying thickness will develop between the curved surface of the lens and plain glass plate. Now this part is important. So at the point of contact, thickness of the air film will be zero, then it gradually increases on either side. So when such film will develop between the curved surface of the lens and plain glass plate, it should be illuminated normally. Now we'll understand the principle of formation of Newton's rings. When monochromatic light is allowed to incident normally on this combination, the incident light will get partly reflected from the upper surface of the film and partly refracted. The refracted light again will get reflected from the lower surface. In this way, we get ray 1 and ray 2. So the light which will get reflected from the upper and lower surfaces will interfere, and an alternate dark and bright rings will be seen in the field of view. These rings are called Newton's rings. So this is the pattern of Newton's rings. So in the field of view, an alternate dark and bright rings will be observed. These rings are called Newton's rings. Aim of this experiment is to determine radius of curvature of a plano-convex lens. Now this formula we are going to use to calculate radius of curvature of plano-convex lens, and theory how we have got this formula, that part we already discussed during theory session. Now quickly discuss the different terms involved in this particular formula. A capital R is radius of curvature of plano convex lens. Now d is the diameter of dark ring. Now in this case dn plus p, this is diameter of n plus pth dark ring. Now dn, this is the diameter of nth dark ring. Lambda is the wavelength of incident light, and in this case lambda will be given. If lambda is known, just by measuring diameters of different rings, very easily we can calculate radius of curvature of a plano convex lens. Now in order to record the readings, we should know the least count of traveling microscope. Now we have used different instruments like vernier caliper, micrometer, spirometer, and we know the standard procedure to calculate least count of all these instruments. Now in order to calculate least count of traveling microscope, this is the formula we are going to use. Least count is equal to value of smallest division on main scale divided by total number of divisions on vernier scale. This is traveling microscope, this is main scale, and this is circular scale or vernier scale. Now as per that formula, value of the smallest division on main scale, this is main scale, and value of the smallest division is 0.1 centimeter. And total number of divisions on a circular scale, there are 100 divisions on circular scale. So if we substitute these values in that formula, we'll get least count. Now as I said, value of smallest division on the main scale is 0.1 centimeter divided by total number of divisions on circular scale, there are 100 divisions. Therefore, least count will be 0.001 centimeter. After calculating the least count, the next step is to calculate total reading. Now, formula to calculate total reading is MSR, that is a main scale reading, plus bracket vernier scale or circular scale reading into least count. So whatever value of vernier scale you will get multiplied by least count, and you will add that value to main scale reading, you will get total reading in centimeter, as we have calculated least count in centimeter. Observations: least count of traveling microscope we have already calculated. Least count is 0.001. Wavelength of sodium lamp, the value is given, 5893 Armstrong unit. Now as we have calculated least count in centimeter, so we'll take lambda in centimeter. 5893 into 10 raised to minus 8 centimeters. Observation table. So these are the elements: number of dark ring n, microscope reading, left x1 centimeter, right x2 centimeter. Now once we record the readings on right and left, very easily we can calculate diameter of that particular ring. That will be the difference between either x2 minus x1 or x1 minus x2, and dn square. So whatever value we'll get, dn, so square of that. Now once we get the circular pattern, it consists of number of dark and bright rings. So we'll concentrate on only dark rings. So there will be number of rings in the field of view, but for our convenience, we'll concentrate on third ring, fourth ring, fifth ring, then 13th dark ring, 14th dark ring, and 15th dark ring. So as per your convenience, you can record the reading for second, third, fourth, as per your convenience. So for our convenience, we are going to record the diameter for 3rd, 4th, 5th, then 13th, 14th, 15th. Now, as we know, in Newton's rings experiment, the assembly of plano convex lens and plain glass plate is important. So this is plano convex lens and this is plain glass plate, and this assembly is inside this black casing. Now, as we have already discussed, this is a monochromatic source light, this is a biconvex lens, the plano convex lens and plain glass plate, that assembly is inside this casing. This is semi silvered glass plate, and as we know, when plano convex lens is placed over plain glass plate, an air film of varying thickness will develop between the curved surface of the lens and plain glass plate, and that film needs to be illuminated normally, and for that the semi silvered glass plate should be placed at an angle 45 degrees. Now, when the film is illuminated normally and when you look through the eyepiece with the help of this traveling microscope, in the field of view an alternate dark and bright rings will be observed. Those rings are called Newton's rings. Now, as we have discussed, as per this observation table, we are going to get this sort of pattern. There will be alternate dark and bright rings. When you look through the eyepiece, there will be dark central spot and alternate dark and bright rings will be there. As we are going to concentrate on only dark rings, so immediately the central dark spot we are not going to consider as a ring. So immediately there will be first dark ring, second dark ring, third ring, fourth, fifth. There will be n number of dark rings. But in order to simplify the case, we are going to concentrate on third ring, fourth, fifth, 13th, 14th, 15th. Okay, because if we go on measuring diameter of a different ring, that would be a very tedious job. So we are going to simplify that part. This is traveling microscope, and with the help of traveling microscope we are going to record all the readings. Now, there are different parts of traveling microscope. This is objective, this is eyepiece. Now, you must be wondering that why it is called as a traveling microscope, because we can rotate this horizontally as well as vertically. Now, when everything is set, when the film is illuminated normally and when we adjust the focusing of objective and eyepiece, in the field of view we get a circular pattern consisting of dark and bright rings. Now, I have adjusted. Now, if you look through the eyepiece, there will be vertical and horizontal crosswire. I have adjusted the crosswires at the center. All of you have seen this sort of pattern, an alternate dark and bright rings, and very easily you can count the rings also. As I said, the central dark spot you are not going to consider as a ring, so you are going to concentrate on 3rd, 4th, 5th, then you will skip the rings in between and then directly 13th, 14th, 15th. Now, the crosswire is at the center. And as I start rotating this circular screw, the crosswire will get shifted either on right or left. Now, there is no instrument to record the diameter directly. Therefore, we are going to divide this pattern into two parts. This is right side, this is left. Now, in observation table also, there are two columns, left and right. So, you will record readings for 3rd, 4th, 5th, 13th, 14th, 15th on right. And then you will rotate the circular screw in reverse direction, and again you will follow the same sequence. You will record the reading for 3rd, 4th, 5th, 13th, 14th, 15th on left. And once we get the readings on right and left, very easily we can calculate the diameter of that particular ring, and then we'll square that value, will get diameter square. Now, I'll show you one reading. Now, the crosswire is at the center. Now looking through the eyepiece, very carefully you're supposed to rotate the circular screw. Don't rotate this in forward, backward, otherwise backlash error will come. So very carefully you're supposed to rotate the screw. So looking through the eyepiece, very easily you can count the number of rings. First, second, third. Now I have adjusted the cross wire on third ring. Now how you supposed to record the reading? Now that part I have already explained. How you supposed to calculate total reading? Now this is a main scale, and to record main scale there is one reference line. You need to see where it coincides. Now in this case, this reference zero, this is in between 5.2 and 5.3. The line is very close to 5.2, so you will record MSR as 5.2 centimeter. To record circular scale reading, again there is one reference line. You need to see where it coincides. Now in this case, the reference line is in between 11 and 12. Now it is very close to 11. If it exactly coincides 12, you will write that, but if it is in between, always take a lower value. So in this case, we are going to record 11. In this way, we have got reading. So our MSR reading is 5.2, and CSR we have got 11. So our final reading will be 5.211 centimeter. So in this way, you will record the reading for the next ring. 4th, 5th, then 13th, 14th, 15th, and then you will rotate the screw in reverse direction and you will follow the same sequence. So by simply recording the readings on right and left, very easily we can calculate the diameter of respective rings, and then we'll square that value, we'll get diameter square. Now after getting diameter square, we are going to plot a graph. You're supposed to plot a graph. Diameter square versus ring number. Okay, and the nature of that graph will be straight line. Once we plot the graph, after that, there is a formula. We have modified the formula which we have seen earlier. Slope, once we get the straight line graph, we'll calculate slope. So slope of the graph divided by 4 lambda. And the lambda is known, that is 5893 into 10 raised to minus 8. So when we substitute all the values, very easily we will get the value of radius of curvature in centimeter. So very systematically we have discussed each and every point, experimental setup, as well as how you supposed to record all the readings. I hope you would have understood all these things.